command post with Erika Angel traveling about the two wide off the fence. Red Lucifer is trailing the field as they begin to negotiate the band and straight up for the final. Running round the turn and into the straight, and it's Omega Man brings them into the home state by a margin of almost a length in front, being joined in the outside by Fierce Fighter. Then comes Southern Aristocrat. The one on the inside is Sandcastles weaving through in between runners. For the back is He's the One. Then comes OCBSA. Red Lucifer takes the shortest way through, but inside the final to 200 meters, and it's Omega Man still continues to lead this field by about two in front, now kicking on gamely to about 2.5 in front of Fierce Fighter, Sandcastles. Then comes the other runners, but the Omega Man has wrapped up the bow just here.
Welcome to the Horsepower Feeds Winner's Circle. Dheeraj Venkateswamy, many congratulations.
Thank you.
Omega Man was certainly looking to pick up the paddock along with Slingshot. And once Slingshot got withdrawn, what did you think at that time?
I was pretty confident of winning this race. But he had run a very good third last time, out 6 furlongs. Yeah, he had very good chances today. After number one getting withdrawn, though, I was pretty confident. I certainly almost won that race. This is a very good horse for this class. I wanted a good jockey also. He was better than this class.
Five lengths behind on the inside is Rule of Law. On the outside, making headway is Sky Princess. Altair comes in next. For the back in the field is Amazing Luck. They've got about 400 to travel. It's Ocean Dunes now challenged in the center by Benediction. On the inside is Belvedere, racing inside the final 300 meters. It's Benediction who's out in front by a length to the better of Ocean Dunes. On the outside, covering good grounds, is Striking Point. Deep inside the final 150 meters, it's Benediction from Striking Point. Benediction is clear, close to about a length in front of Striking Point.
आज अलग तो कुछ नहीं है. आज लास्ट टाइम भी मैं बहुत फैंसी किया था, बट लास्ट टाइम क्या थोड़ा एक्वाड जंप ले लिया था और वो थोड़ा जॉकी इंट्रैक्शन भी फॉलो नहीं किया था. थोड़ा एक्वाड जंप लिया, वो थोड़ा पीछे लेके बढ़ गया था और आज जॉकी को ऑलरेडी पहले से ही बोल दिया था, टेक अ गुड जंप, टेक अ गुड लॉन्ग रेंज, एंड ही रोड इंट्रैक्शन भी फॉलो किया, बहुत अच्छी राइड किया उसको.
They've got about 500 meters to travel. It's Splendido, who's about a length and a half to the better of Stormwatch. On the inside is Siege Courageous. On the outside is Bellissimo. With final 300 to travel, it's Splendido, about a length and a half to the better of Stormwatch in the center. On the outside is Siege Courageous. Inside the final 200 meters, it's Splendido, still kicking on gamely, about a length to the better of Siege Courageous. Deep inside the final 50 meters, it's Splendido, who's out in front by 3 lengths in front of Siege Courageous.
Welcome to the Horsepower Feeds Winner's Circle, Mr. Padmanabhan. Many congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
The son of Win Legend is his third start. He's won now, finally today. You dropped him back in distance last time. He was at 1200 meters and this time now back in 1400. Do you think he'll go longer?
I think he'll go a little longer. At the moment, you know, we don't know what was his right trip. So it was, we were fumbling a bit. And we put blinkers, he's more focused with blinkers. So I think he's got scope to improve.
the home state and begin to negotiate the bend. Colonel Artie is not far behind. Then comes Inner Breeze and Peo almost together, with Douglas right on the haunches of Peo. Pelush comes in next as they begin to negotiate the bend and straighten for the final run. And round the turn and into the straight, and it's Bill Brook shopping a stride from Extraordinary. And the one which is getting that run in between runners is Peo. And back behind them is Inner Breeze, been produced on the outside. So too is Douglas. But Peo towards the rails from Millbrook. These two are the joint leaders. Then comes another length and a quarter behind is Douglas. Extraordinary. But Peo is shot into the lead by about a length and a quarter to two in front. And is now going to win the Kunigal Start Stakes.
He is a very nice horse. Out of six, he has won four races. A very genuine horse, very genuine. He's given 6 kgs to Douglas and 9 kgs to other horses. With 55 and a half, he had won. Now he has won with 60 kgs. Actually, I was a little worried with the favorite horse in this race. I thought, you know, how can I give 6 kgs? And he has, in his previous outing, he has already beaten me. So I was a little worried about that. But that going was very bad that particular day where he ran off the board. Otherwise, 4 out of 6 wins. I think his best is 1400 meters, so I always try to keep him at 1400.
Sardar is not far behind being John on the outside, but Domingo Super Veloz. Royal Grant is next, then we have Bruce Almighty as they swing around the corner and take up for the final run. And little over 500 to travel is the running of the Justice League made up of Memorial Cup. And Angel Bliss now being covered on the outside by Kulsum. These two are battling it out. Then we have Super Veloz. Sardar comes in next. Domingo is now being switched over on the inside, but inside the final 200 meters. Kulsum on the outside fights back towards the railing is Angel Bliss. They're going a ding-dong battle, but it's Kulsum on the outside from Angel Bliss, Kulsum from Angel Bliss, Kulsum from Angel Bliss. It's Angel Bliss, Kulsum, Angel Bliss, Kulsum, Angel Bliss, Kulsum in a touch and go.
Kulsum has been one of the most sweet animals I've ever owned in my life. In 30, 35 years of owning horses, Kulsum has been really, I think, the best for me. Such a sweet animal, I can't tell you. I love her and so I came for her. I've come all the way from Bombay and she's unbelievable. I made Yaya bunk school and brought him with me. I said, I think she'll do it for you today, and she's done it.
That's so sweet. So was bunking school worth it?
Yes, definitely, definitely. It was very close, very close. I thought she lost even after she finished.
Dot is holding the fence. On the outside in improving positions is La Reina, another 3.5 lengths. Then driven along at the stage is moving ahead. They're traveling towards the final 400 meters. It's Tarivin now challenged in the center by another rainbow. Another length and 3/4 away on the outside is La Reina. Looking through the shortest way is Tranquilo. Deep inside the final 200 meters. It's Tranquilo on the inside. In the center, we've got another rainbow. On the outside is La Reina. It's Tranquilo from La Reina. Tranquilo's clear. Crossed over length and a half in front of La Reina.
The first horse I bred, Amita gave me the mare free, Tegbir gave me a covering free, and a friend bought it, so it's a special horse for me. It's the only horse I have a mane with because it's blonde in color and it's wrong to cut something that's blonde in color, and he's a very special horse for me, and I'm happy that he could win today. So I have a program of running him in one of the colts trial. Hopefully it would be something nice to win, and let's look forward to his future racing.
Now let's talk about John's ride. He didn't use the whip in typical John fashion.
Yeah, he's not a whip-happy jockey, and I've seen to it that he doesn't remain a whip-happy jockey, and he just nurses horses and gets the best out of them. Today, he the horse was coming out of his head back. He had very bad sessions after his last run. We rested him for 3-4 weeks, brought him back, so I didn't want to punish him because I have greater plans for him.
Five lengths behind is Casey, followed next in the field by Debonair. Another four lengths behind is Lagopus. They've got about 400 meters to travel. It's Mark One, still calling the shots, about three lengths in front of Flying Quest. On the outside is Divine Blessings, produced about three wide off the fences, perfect condition. Deep inside the final 150 meters, it's Mark One, who's out in front by two lengths to the better of Divine Blessings, is bridging the gap. On the outside is perfect condition. Inside the final 50 meters, it's Mark One, who's clear by a length to the better of Divine Blessings.
Welcome to the Horsepower Feeds Winner Circle. We're here with the winning connections of Mark One. Now, she was beautifully placed at the scales. She had the perfect draw. The jockey gave her a beautiful ride and like completely in form coming into this race.
Yeah, that's what we thought right from the beginning, you know, that she's drawn one. We have to take, you know, jockey's got to take that opportunity of the draw and make sure that she takes a good jump and just let her run the way she, because she's a one pace horse. And you notice in the last part, she begins to stop. So that's the advantage. You take, you know, take at least 3-4 lengths of the other horses, and then you've got every chance. And of course, I've got to congratulate the trainer, Amar Singh. He's done a wonderful job with this filly. She's won 2 back-to-back races, which I think, congratulations to him. We'd like to thank the owners also, Nitin and Jatin, for giving this horse to Amar Singh. He's done a wonderful job with this filly.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मेरे ऑनर को देखकर और मेरे रेसिंग मैनेजर मिस्टर फिलिप वुड्स एंड बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मेरा स्टेबल टीम वर्क एंड चौकी भी बहुत अच्छा राइड किया ड्रॉन वन था टेक अ गुड जंप और गुड जंप आई एम वेरी हैप्पी द सेकंड विनर हुआ था
I saw this filly's last run and she won very impressively in heavy going. And I also worked this filly because MR Singh sir asked me to ride this filly in the race. So I was quite confident of the win because she worked too good. So just I got simple instructions, hit the front and keep going and make your pace and just kick on. She won quite impressively.
Now you're riding Trafalgar tomorrow. Trafalgar is the winner of the Calcutta Derby. He's a really good horse, winner of the Super Mile as well. You worked him?
First of all, he's a multi-classic winner and getting to sit on that horse is a very big thing. I really want to thank James sir for giving me this ride. I've worked him, I've been working him daily. So fingers crossed for tomorrow. I hope he runs a big race.
The length behind on the outside is Mega Success as they begin to negotiate the bend. Southern Warrior in the order as they take them for the final run. And Divine Masculine brings them into the home straight by a margin of almost about a length in front. Super Ruffian is the one which is looking good on the outside. Comes and joins the issue and just breezes past the front runner. Super Ruffian goes ahead by about a length and a quarter to two in front. Now striding clear and has wrapped up the space. Well, it's a long way clear for the Burgess Chiswick Division 1 is almost about 5 in front and is going to win the last race of the evening from Tokamak.
She's run a good second last time out with Indu Singh in the higher class, and now she's running the lower class and with John handling. She worked good, so you know, she had all the chances to win. It looked easy, but I know how difficult this horse is. You know, you need to really know how to ride her. And John just rode her absolutely good.
I'm happy for the end of the season, so finally got double. The horse is showing a lot of... He's not a lot of class, and she is only A class or class 5B, and she had a lot of issues. She had earlier, like, you know, beginning of the season, she was slowly off. Then she was troubling with the trainer. So trainer told me, like, you know, John, take her and, like, give her a jump out. So I jumped out, she jumped well with me. So last time it was bottom weight, I couldn't ride. So the boy, you know, he gave a good ride, but ran second. Now again, she came to, like, you know, class down. So trainer told me, please, you ride it. Then I said yes. And drawn bad, I said, John, you take it, like, you give her confidence. Then basically, like, you know, drawn 11, carrying 60 ton up back. I didn't want to use her much. Wherever she's comfortable, give her a chance. Wait till the 400 meters. And she was like, you know, she was happy. So I didn't want to punish her. She's doing herself like one, like, you know, she wants to do anything. So I give her the best chance for her. She won very comfortably. And then I don't punish her horse. I know the horse is doing very well. So I didn't want to punish her horse.